Fibromyalgia is a very common condition. It affects perhaps up to 5 to 7% of the US population. It is a diffuse pain syndrome. We can think of fibromyalgia as individuals who have enhanced sensitivity to a variety of environmental triggers. The early symptoms of fibromyalgia are most characteristically pain. Pain can often be associated in one location, and then subsequently over time, that one location pain begins to evolve and spread to become diffuse and all over. Accompanying that pain is often fatigue. So sometimes patients will come to us with the chief complaint of just being tired all the time. Our research regarding fibromyalgia was prompted by lack of a diagnostic blood test for this particular condition, and the fact that patients with fibromyalgia will be searching around for upwards of 5 years looking for a diagnosis. During that particular period of time, those patients are subject to typically MRI scans, various invasive procedures, including spinal taps, amongst others, just seeking a diagnosis. Studies have looked at the cost, the health costs of patients with fibromyalgia. You'll find that those numbers are similar to patients who are on very expensive biologic or various chemotherapies for other conditions. We took 15 patients with fibromyalgia, and we took 15 patients with rheumatoid arthritis, osteoarthritis, and lupus. And then what we used is we used some methodology called spectroscopy. Spectroscopy involves shining a laser through a blood sample. The laser, when it interacts with the blood cells, and specifically with the chemicals in the blood cells, vibrates. And that vibration creates what we call a fingerprint. The question we asked is the fingerprint of patients with fibromyalgia similar enough that we can differentiate individuals with fibromyalgia from rheumatoid, osteo, and other common arthritic conditions? So in our initial study, looking at 15 patients with fibromyalgia compared to 15 in other groups, we had 100% accuracy in being able to differentiate individuals with fibromyalgia from the other rheumatic conditions. We then did a subsequent study where we looked at 50 patients with fibromyalgia, compared them to 50 patients with rheumatoid, 50 patients with lupus, and again, we had 100% accuracy in being able to differentiate these fingerprints between subjects. We took this information to the National Institutes of Health, and we proposed looking at 500 patients. And of course, if we were able to show the same level of sensitivity and specificity with that higher number, then we have a diagnostic blood test. So anything that we can do to enhance a diagnosis and further hone in on the specific chemical moieties that lead to the propagation of pain in these individuals, that is what prompted our investigations to try and develop a specific biomarker for fibromyalgia.